I humbly request you stop your medicines for 3 to 4 days. What happens to your pressure? Probably you may end up with a stroke. So what have you treated? Have you treated the blood pressure? You have treated the symptom, not the cause. You have treated the symptom, not the cause. When you are anxious, when you are tense, you don't get sleep in the night. Some people do say we don't get sleep. What do you finally resort to? Go to the doctor. Doctor, do me one favor. Give me one. What tablet will you say? Sleeping pill. Good. Very good. Correct answer. Sleeping pill. You take the tablet an hour and a half before going to bed. You go to sleep. You doze off. Next day morning you get up. What happens? Sorry? You feel fine. But there's a corollary to it. The thought which was disturbing you prior to going to sleep, the same thought comes back to your mind. So you ask the doctor, doctor, give me a sleeping tablet. Show me one doctor who has prescribed a tablet to say, take one tablet for peace of mind. Is there any doctor who can say, you take this tablet which will give you peace of mind?
It does not exist.
So peace comes from within. Peace comes from within. We rely so much on our five senses. I have seen this person. I hear. I listen. I feel. And we form judgments knowingly or unknowingly. These judgments remain fixed, engraved in our subconscious mind. And at some point of time, when there's a trigger or a coincidence, we start thinking and correlating with that particular event and start forming judgments which harm us very badly. The best thing in life is, if you want peace, be non-judgmental. Be non-judgmental. Meaning, as far as possible, be to yourself, do some meditation, and you'll be totally, totally at ease. Control your thoughts and feelings. Can you control your thoughts and feelings? You cannot. Why not?
It comes and goes.
It comes and goes. Okay. Now, I like this man's honesty, but I will solve this problem. What's your good name?
Raj.
You cannot control your thoughts and feelings. I mean, that's your perception. Now, coming back to perception, I'll tell you one small story. You know, there was one minister all ministers, what they... So there was one fellow selling fans. See, and he was passing by in the village. The minister was in his home, farmhouse. He sees that man and says, "Bhai, what is the cost of this fan?" He's saying, "Sahab, 2000 rupiah." That fellow is saying, 2000 rupiah? That person selling the fan is saying, he's fleeced people worth crores of rupees. Why can't I ask him 2000 for the fan? He's saying, what is wrong with this fan? What is so good about this fan? It's a very peculiar fan. You must know how to use it. It will last you for 100 years. He's saying, is it? Then that man was given a bet. The minister says, chalo, theek hai, give him 2000 rupees. Very, very enthusiastically starts using the fan. In 4 days, the fan becomes like this. The minister becomes very furious. He's saying, this damn fellow cheated me. He's saying, what happened? He calls that fellow and says, bhai, kya ho gaya? He's saying, no, what I said was right, this fan will last me for 100 years. So he's saying, but it has not lasted me for 4 days, what are you talking of, 1 year? He's saying, no, you did not know how to use the fan. He's saying, you did not know how to use the fan, you're telling me. Then actually explain to me what you should do. I said, you should keep the fan steady and start moving your head up and down. So that is the perception. What is the point in talking? People make us angry like this only. And you give him a chance to make you angry means he's conquered over you. Let the opposite person feel this. See, a small fellow like this could change the mind of the minister. He said, bhaiya, tumko malum nahi. Khali pankha hai sa sidha pakadna, khali mundi wala ka tumko. He's saying, but you never told me. He said, I thought you being a minister and so powerful, you should have known this. So always remember, it is the perception of the person which is important. See, over here, what you may feel is right, the other person may feel is wrong. But no, in this spiritual and divine talks, it is God's way of putting certain seeds in your mind. Now, coming back to your thoughts and thinking, if today you have a very good rapport with me and you need me badly, you want to contact me, what will you do? Okay. You'll call me soon.
Yeah.
Means
you?
Obviously, okay. You call me. I will not pick up the phone. I will not pick up the phone.
He will be upset.
Okay. But what? Come on, tell me. What will you do?
Anger.
Sorry?
Find out your address.
Office address.
Find out my address. I said, don't come. Get out.
Wrongly if I think
You are right, but still, in one particular case, let us make it very, very, very abnormal. I refuse to listen to your thoughts.
Then I have to forget about it.
There you are. See, he has come with his own answer of changing his thought. You had a thought of contacting me.
I said there is something different.
1 minute, please. Cool down. What happens over here?
I tried a different options.
You tried all possible options. So same way, my friend, we keep getting thoughts after thoughts per day. How many thoughts do we get in a day, approximately?
60,000.
On an average, we get 60,000 thoughts per day. This has been proved scientifically in the University of Stanford, where research was done. But we pay attention only to certain thoughts. We pay attention. Okay, on an average, how many per hour?
3,000.
No, on an average. We will divide by?
20,000.
No, 16, because you sleep 8 hours.
There also a thought. Dream is also a thought.
Dream is, but you see, there, I'm saying on an average. Because there you are in a totally different state. As he rightly says, you are in a different alpha state. So you get about 3,750 thoughts per hour. So what is it finally boiling down to? Repetition and clutter. Now the beauty of your thinking power is like this. Unfortunately, 80% of these same thoughts are repeated the next day. So now if you start thinking, my boss is bad, he's harassing me, my husband is bullying me. Sorry?
They are irrelevant.
They are thoughts, they are bugging a person. They have an effect on your health and mind. But when you go to sleep and next day when you get up, the same thought starts bugging you. So it's a repetition. So indirectly you are putting these seeds, negative seeds in your subconscious mind. See, what is your subconscious mind like? It's like a beautiful soldier. It only takes commands. It cannot do anything. Anybody have been on a ship? You've been good. Good. See what happens? The captain is on the deck. The marine staff are inside. Whatever he talks from top, these people just implicitly follow the commands. They do not know what they are doing, which direction they are going in. The same thing is with your subconscious mind. So now, a very simple thing is to learn how to start talking to your thoughts and emotions. Can you talk to your thoughts and emotions? No. Can you get some feeling? Can you talk to your thoughts? You cannot. Take up his example, which he rightly said, I'll try contacting you. Then what happens to his energy level after some time? It starts dissipating and coming down, slowly down, slowly down. So same thing. Would anyone like to take an example of his own thought which is bugging him and share with us over here? If he does not mind, of course. Any volunteer? Maybe a very simple thought. Maybe a thought in the office, maybe it's a thought in his family, something bugging him. Talk to that thought. Literally talk. Believe me, don't ask me how this process is working. Will it work? Can it work? It will never work. The important thing is total faith and surrender. Just faith and surrender in what I am teaching you. Do not start analyzing. What is the brother's name of analysis? Do you know? Paralysis.